In this video, I will take you through the full process of setting up an intercom telephone system, which is also called Private Automatic Branch Exchange, or PABX. After our setup, we would be able to use this phone to call this other phone, or vice versa, that is, from this to this. Or even in instances where you have more than two telephone handsets, you can use any of the handsets to call any other handset within your setup. We will be using this PBX switch. It is a 16 extension switch, but we will be using just two of each extension jacks, since we will be wiring up for just two handsets. We will also be using these two telephone sockets, and we will be wiring them up through which we will connect our telephone handsets. For connecting cables, we will use Cat5 cables. I have short samples of Cat5 cables here. We'll be fitting RJ11 plugs on the Cat5 cables. So I have also my RJ11 plugs ready here, and we'll be using them on the cables. Here are the tools we'll be using. This one is a crimping tool. This is also a cutter for cutting the cables. I also have here a knife to be used in peeling the cables. And we also have the punch down tool, which we'll be using to terminate cables to the Keystone jacks. So let's start with our setup. The first step is to lay cables from each of the telephone socket locations to the PBX switch, which is normally placed at the central location. Here is my first Cat5 cable that I will be running from the first socket to the PBX switch. I will mark each end of this cable as 1. This is to help in identifying the cable in cases where you are working with many cables. I'm supposed to lay it from the socket to the PBX switch, so I will place it like this. Here is my second cable. I will mark it as 2. So I will create 2 marks here, indicating number 2. And this end 2, I will create the mark. So this serves as the cable run between the second socket and the PBX switch. Let's now start with our terminations. For these ends that will go into the PBX switch, we'll fix the RJ11 plugs. The cable labeled number 2 will be used for this single line telephone, whilst the cable number 1 will be used for this multi-line telephone. Let's start with cable number 1. I'll cut off the end, gently peel off the insulation. I'll be using the blue and orange pairs, so I'll cut out the green and brown pairs. So I'll just untwist the pairs. I'll trim the cables. I'll place the cables into the RJ11. Crimp the cable using the crimping tool. Here is my terminated cable. I'll push it into extension jack 1, which is 601 here. I will terminate the second cable as well. So my second cable is ready. I will be placing it into extension jack 2, which is 602 here. So I'll plug it. The next step is to wire up the sockets. Here is the first socket. I will let in the cable through the side of the patches box, like this. So I'll then mark the insulation and then take off the insulation. I'll cut off the green and brown pairs. We are left with the blue and orange pairs. I'll just untwist them. I'll place them on the Keystone Jack, following the color coding in the Keystone Jack that you can see here. So the solid orange goes here, the striped orange, the solid blue, and the striped blue. You press them down very well. So I'm now going to punch each of them down. So this socket is ready. To close the patch rest, you can just remove the front and use these two holes to screw it to the patch rest box and close back the front panel. Let's repeat the same process for this other socket. We will be terminating only the blue pair, since this cable will be used to serve just a single line telephone. So I can just put the rest aside whilst terminating just the blue pair. We will pass it into the patches box and twist the blue pair. Mount it on the Keystone Jack and then punch them down. You can see that we have terminated just the blue pair, and that is enough to get any single line telephone fully functional on this socket. Here is a flexible cable I will use to connect my single line telephone from the socket. So I'll just plug it into the line port of the phone and plug the other end into the socket. This one is a 4-wire flexible cable that I will use to connect the multi-line telephone. I'll plug it into this phone and plug the other end into the socket. Now the layout is set and I'm left with power into the PBX switch. So I'll plug the AC cord in here and put into my socket. You can see the display for this phone is on. In order to make the first call, we can just use the default extension codes for each of the extension jacks we have wired. The display phone is on extension 601 and the other phone is on 602 as written by each of the extension jacks here. So from this phone we can dial 601 and you can hear this one ringing. You can also see it blinking, which is an indication that there is an incoming call. You can in the same way use this one to call 02, and you can hear it ringing as well. There are diverse features and functions that you can program onto your PBX switch through system programming. But this is all I have for you today, so there is still more to share on PBX. If you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, please subscribe to Tech Inside Out. And please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.